A private key simply explained. Hey and welcome. My name is Julian, and today I want to explain to you what a private key in cryptocurrencies is and why it really matters. Now, imagine you are a company and you want to give accounts to people, similar like, for example, Gmail does with emails. Now, what you basically do is, whenever someone wants an account, since you have a database of all the accounts, you go and say, okay, this email address, this account is already taken, so you need to take another one. But if we have a decentralized system, there's no one who actually checks on the accounts. So what to do? Well, actually, the solution is genius. You go and you create all the accounts up front, and since this is digital, it's pretty much for free. In the case of Bitcoin, for example, 2 to the power of 256 accounts have been created, and that is the private keys. Now, when any person wants to join a cryptocurrency or a blockchain, instead of having to pick an account like on Gmail, just randomly pick one of those huge numbers of private keys. In the case of Bitcoin, that's a number with 80 zeros. It's a huge amount of possibilities. And the odds that someone else has picked the same account is literally zero. And so the only thing now that you have to remember is, which account did you pick? Because if you forget which account you picked, you can't write to someone and say, hey, can you please restore my account? Because no one knows which one you had. And so this is why it is so essential to store your private key, or what many times is called a seed, which is nothing else than a 12 or 24 string word that generates this private key through a cryptographic process. So the key thing, and in this case, it's really a pun intended, make sure that you never, ever, ever lose your private key, because otherwise, you don't know which one of this sheer huge amount of possibilities of private keys you picked in any given cryptocurrencies.